A few weeks ago, I lost my wallet, which made me sad because it is a pain to get everything replaced. And then I thought, what kind of person doesn't return a wallet? And then I thought, I'm a firm believer in the scientific method, I should test some hypotheses. So I got 200 identical wallets in order to drop them in each of the 20 cities you see here. The goal being not only to see which cities were the most and least honest, but to ask questions of anyone who called in to see if I could pick out some patterns among the honest ones. And I wanted to make the wallets look as real as possible, so in each of them, I put a fake ID with no picture so as not to bias people, $6 American and 200 Filipino dollars. This is a way to make it look like a lot of money when in reality, this is only worth $4. Then I put in an ultrasound picture and on the back, we hand wrote a date from 4 years ago and then this adorable picture of a puppy I found on Reddit. The goal was in addition to the ID and the money, I wanted to make it look like the wallet had sentimental value to the owner. I was trying to remove any excuse for someone not to return the wallet, such as it looked fake or it wouldn't be worth the hassle if there was only $2 inside of a blank wallet. So in our case, if they didn't return it, it would only be because they weren't being honest. Then we had a fake loyalty card and a random business card, and then critically, a card that looked like it came with the wallet that said, if found, please call, and then we wrote the phone number. And then because it's impractical for me to actually visit 20 cities, I went on the Instagram page for my YouTube channel to ask for help, and right away, the response was awesome. Once I had selected my 20 helpers, I sent them instructions and shipped them each 10 wallets. And then last Monday, all across North America, Operation Wallet Drop commenced. After they dropped the wallets to try and get some secret footage if possible. And to do that, they came up with some pretty clever methods.
I'm actually gonna tuck the wallet underneath my car, so when I drive away, it stays in the parking lot.
Immediately, calls started pouring in from all of the cities. So when people would call in, we asked them 8 questions, such as if they were religious or not, or if there was still money in the wallet when they found it. And if so, of course, we told them just to keep it. So after 3 days of collecting data, here's what we found. For starters, and this blew my mind, 2/3 of the wallets were returned. And of those that were returned, 96% still had the money inside. The average age of one of the callers was 36, which is almost exactly the average age of a person in the US. So how old you are doesn't seem to affect honesty. There's a pretty big disparity in which cities were the most and least honest, and I'll get to the rankings in just a minute. But first I wanted to test a hypothesis that a person without a lot of money and considered poor would be less likely to return the wallet than someone who had a lot of money. And to do this, I looked up publicly available census data and found the zip codes with the highest and lowest medium income. And then I instructed my friends helping in each city to randomly drop half the wallets in the high income area of the city and then the other half in the low income area. And each wallet was marked with a unique number on the back of this card, so we knew exactly which city and location if somebody called it in. And when we tallied it up, 60 wallets were called in from the high income areas and exactly 60 wallets were also returned from the low income areas, which I thought was pretty cool. So a rich person is no more likely to return a wallet than someone in the lowest income bracket who could probably use the money. In fact, we had one person call in who was homeless, 2 people call in who were living in shelters, and a 4th person who was a panhandler. All 4 of them had full wallets. Another question I wanted to test was if women were more honest than men. It turns out a majority of the wallets were returned by men. But if you think about it, that doesn't necessarily mean they are more honest, because maybe the locations they were dropped, there's typically more men, like in front of a sports bar or a hardware store. So to control for this, I had all my helping friends in each city drop 2 of the 10 wallets in a men's restroom and then 2 in a women's bathroom. This way we could control the gender of the wallet finder. Once again, this came up nearly identical with 23 wallets returned for men versus 24 for women. So gender doesn't seem to play a role in a person's honesty either. And I should mention here, one of the questions we asked the callers was if they thought the wallet looked fake or suspicious at all. And only a very small minority did, so this confirms that for those who didn't call, it was likely because they were dishonest and not because they thought it wasn't a real person's wallet. Another thing we tested was small town versus big city. So you notice 4 of the cities you've probably never heard of before. That's because they have populations of around 1,000 people, whereas the rest were the largest cities in North America. And here we did see a significant difference. In the small town, the average rate of return was 8 wallets, whereas in the big cities, it was 6. And I think this sort of makes sense to me, because small towns tend to foster a sense of community where everyone knows everyone versus the anonymity of a big city. And now for a rundown of all the cities, I'll break them into 3 categories. Starting with the least honest, we've got Detroit with 3 wallets returned and New York City with 4. I was really rooting for Detroit and hoping they would just surprise everyone, but it looks like maybe they're still in the process of their rebuilding efforts. Then for the middle of the pack, at 5 wallets returned, we've got Seattle, Los Angeles, Miami, Dallas, and Edmonton. Then at 6 wallets returned, we've got Huntsville, Alabama, and New London, Connecticut, which is one of our small towns. Next at 7 wallets, we've got San Francisco, Winnipeg, and Washington, D.C. The final category is the Honest Abe cities, with Parma, Idaho, and Las Vegas at 8 wallets. And I should mention for Vegas, instead of high income and low income, we put half on the strip and then half in the suburbs. And for what it's worth, all 5 dropped on the strip were returned. And then at a remarkable 9 wallets return, we've got 2 more small cities with Nashua, Idaho, and Hill City, South Dakota, and then Portland, Oregon, making Fred and Carrie proud. And finally, there were 2 cities with an astounding 100% return rate. Both were big cities, with Chicago, which I didn't see coming, and then Salt Lake City. And before you just chalk Salt Lake City up to those gosh darn super nice Mormons, in Salt Lake, of the 8 people we were able to interview, only 3 said they were religious, and only 1 attended church. In fact, about 40% of the people who turned in wallets said they were not religious. And this is close enough to the average for a large city that it's fair to say that whether or not a person was religious seemed to have no outcome on their honesty, according to our data. And I should also mention that while our 2 Canadian cities finished right in the middle of the pack, my Canadian friend saw this on his Facebook page right after dropping his wallets. And going the extra mile with a blanket Facebook post to find a random wallet owner is just about the most Canadian thing ever. We also dropped 10 wallets in Disneyland, and we were hoping to get a large number back, but we only got 4 calls from individuals and then 2 from security, who were super confused when they had identical wallets turned in, at which point they made it very clear they would not be calling us back if more wallets came in, because they hate science. So we had to throw Disneyland out as a data point because we just don't know how many got turned into security. So those were the findings, and I'd say from all this, I learned 2 things. The first is that it's a really good idea to put your phone number somewhere in your wallet. That's probably one of the reasons we had such a high rate of return. Also, I found out if you find a wallet, you can drop it in any US post office box, and then we'll return it to the address found on the driver's license, free of charge. I tested this out, and it totally works. And the second thing is that in general, people are way more honest than I originally thought. Having just lost my wallet, I was anticipating a return rate of maybe 20%. So to get 2 out of every 3 wallets back blew my mind. In one city, a convenience store owner loved what we were doing, so she kept putting the wallet back in the bathroom to see if someone would steal it. And after 6 times of somebody bringing the wallet back with all of the money inside, she gave up trying. Lately, it seems like so much of what you see online is meant to stoke outrage at some group of people versus ourselves, because that's what gets shared. And that begins to warp our perspectives, that the only good people out there are those within our own group. But this cold hard data shows that across any age or gender or socioeconomic background, across the whole religious spectrum, through middle America and along the coast, there are lots of good people everywhere. And not only that, but they constitute a majority. These people didn't call it for some reward or Facebook likes or because they knew someone was watching. They did it because it was simply the right thing to do. And I think that's pretty cool and something worth remembering. Thanks for watching.